I am a magnet for anything financial. People talk to me about everything that moves, whether it's something I've followed for decades or something I'm furiously studying so I can keep up with what's working. The late, great Mark Haynes always called me Reverend Jim Bob from the Church of What's Happening Now. That was my moniker, because back then I had much more of a short-term focus. If Mark Haynes were still around and still hosting Squawk Box, the first thing he'd ask me is, what do I think about GameStop and AMC, the pair of meme stocks that exploded higher today? I tell him that AMC is a great reopening story with a mountain of debt, far more than its operations can cover. But because there's a group of rabid investors who'll buy any amount of stock, even tens of millions of shares if CEO Adam Aron were to offer them, we don't need to worry about the balance sheet. I tell them there's a Reddit message board called Wall Street Bets, and those people will snap up new shares of AMC in a heartbeat. They'll buy because Wall Street Bets commanded it. And that's what matters right now. As for GameStop, I'd say it was run by a Svengali, Ryan Cohen, someone who's worshipped by the same cadre, and he too can do whatever he wants, including nothing. The stock will rally anyway because Wall Street Bets demands it and can keep climbing until they've run out of firepower, which seems nowhere near the 200 level. Mark would ask, what's all those colored things they put up? What's this moon stuff? And I'd say, it's just some sort of silly rallying cry. But because I say things like that, these people hate me. They didn't want to know what else they'd be championing. And I said, nothing. Mark would consider that unimpressive. What else? He definitely asked me about Cathie Wood, the money manager behind ARK Invest, who had great performance last year, but has been struggling this year. The old me, Reverend Jim Bob from the Church of What's Happening Now, would say she got Tesla right, so nothing else matters. He'd question if that's really enough. But for the people chasing momentum stocks, the answer is, of course. Mark would notice that she's from the Church of What's Happening Then, which is not as good as the Church of What's Happening Now, which would bring us to cryptocurrency. I can just imagine him again asking me up front, isn't him one big phony, Kramer? He'd want to know why I sold most of my Bitcoin and Ethereum near the peak. The truth is I got lucky because I literally forgot I owned it and I needed some cash to buy a farm. Then I tell him the dirty truth. When it comes to the younger generation, nobody cares about stocks anymore, Mark. They just care about crypto. There are lots of younger operators that do nothing but trade various cryptocurrencies, of course, on margin, maybe in slivers, hoping they ignite. And they're making these bets with borrowed money, sometimes as much as 100-to-1. Well, Mark would say, well, that'll end badly. I'd reserve judgment. It'll probably will bad someday, but I mean, like, who cares? That doesn't mean it'll be soon and you could miss out on some big gains in the interim. Boy, would that ever be me? Virtually every day, some new cryptocurrency turns into a quality asset and new millionaires are made. Plus, you got a legion of proselytizers like Mike Novogratz. I see him on TV periodically. And Anthony Pompliano, Pop, who makes these things sound incredibly enticing, blue chip, even when the whole crypto edifice has spent the last month getting crushed. The truth is, it's hard to keep up with all the new ones. Like Tether, it acts as some sort of wild transfer agent from cash to crypto. They'll tell me it's not new, but it's new to me. One that raises eyebrows. Hey, maybe both eyebrows. Or Dogecoin, which started as a dumb joke. Perhaps the joke's on you if you missed out on the stunning move over the past 6 months. Mark would then ask if crypto is just like sports betting. I would say no. On the one hand, it's less rigorous than sports betting. On the other hand, you can put less money to work and potentially generate far better returns. That's when he'd throw up his hands and he'd say, if that's all young people want to talk about, then go study it and let me know if there's any way to help you. And that's what I'm doing. Honestly, there's not a lot of rigor to the process, but to Reverend Jim Bob of the Church of What's Happening Now, what matters is that Elon Musk makes the best, most environmentally friendly cars, and he likes crypto, at least today. Cathie Wood loves it, too, and they're the expert who matters. Who will be right long term? Who cares? Remember, that's the old me. As long as they're on the same team again, I think that the two of those people can get the whole thing going. Musk and Wood, you can't beat that, right? And as for the memory of Mark Haynes, we have something special to offer. CNBC is auctioning off an NFT of his famous bottom call in March of 2009. Now, I don't think he'd be an NFT guy. Actually, not at all. But he'd like that all proceeds go to charity. Autism Speaks and the Council for Economic Education. You can bid on it at mintable.app/CNBC until tomorrow morning at 10:30. And I want you.